Yeah, because it's time for a Super Bowl. Well, this weekend it is. But right now, we want to get you to step up your game on the game day menu for the Super Bowl.
Lifestyle expert Limor Suss has some fun ideas to impress your guests and keep them fed throughout the day, because that's what it's all about. You know, for me, I'm not super into the game, but I am into the food.
Yes.
And hosting. I like having people over that watch the game, but I'm all about the food.
That's true. And a lot of people for the food and for the commercials. And so for the first thing what
and
I have.
And the halftime.
And the halftime show is a snack stadium.
This
is so cool.
What I've done here, so we've done variations of this in the past, but this is, you just get one of these snack stadiums. You can get it right at the party store, and I filled it up with all different kinds of snacks. So we have pretzel crisps, we have tortilla chips, different kinds.
Kinds of dip.
And then these we were just talking about are little pretzel balls. And then, of course, in the center on the field, we have different dips. So we have French onion dip, we have spinach artichoke dip, some queso, some guacamole, and some salsa.
Super easy.
And then your friends can just breeze, and it's delicious.
Of course, you want your vegetable tray, right?
Yes, exactly. So with the snack stadium, if you want something a little bit healthier, you can also put it, if you don't have one of these big snack stadiums, you can just put it on like a nice tray and put a little football in the center and you're all set.
You know, I used to be that buffalo wings and like pizza were the go-to.
Yes.
But now it's all about switching it up and variations on certain things, right? So what do you got here?
Okay, so before we get to the buffalo chicken dip, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you over here the cheese platter tray.
Oh, that's cute.
And so all you do is you can just buy the store bought like cut up cheese, and then it makes it easier if you use an oval platter, but if not, you start putting it into an oval shape. On the outside of the perimeter, I have pretzel crisps, but you can also use crackers. I have salami in the center to look like a football. And then I just took a like a polio string cheese like this.
Yeah.
And then I just made the laces and really easy and delicious.
Awesome. You know, this is super
creative.
Easy. And this is very impressive when your guests come in. And
I know. They're like, oh, you slaved really hard. It takes like 5 minutes.
Exactly.
But this is going to be a crowd pleaser.
Yes, so this is a crowd pleaser. And so buffalo chicken wings are delicious, but they get really messy. So this is a mess-free way to enjoy buffalo wings. Mm-hmm. It's a buffalo wing dip. So you're going to help me out.
Sure, here we go.
So I have 8 ounces of cream cheese right here.
Uh-huh.
To that, you're going to add the Frank's Red Hot, about half a cup of that.
Okay.
Then you're going to add ranch dressing, blue cheese, both a half a cup of that as well, and then 2 cups of the shredded rotisserie chicken, just the chicken
breast. This is so super easy.
You bake it in the oven, you mix it all together, bake it in the oven for about 375 for about 20 minutes until it's nice and gooey. I like to put it in a slow cooker so it stays warm throughout your party. And it's really easy.
You know what's great about this is you buy the rotisserie chicken already made.
Yes.
You just kind of shred it all together. So you're really not doing a whole lot of work.
You're really not doing a whole lot of work, exactly. And then you can double the recipe if you wanted to have
trust me, this
is double the recipe.
You will want to double the recipe because this is delicious. It's like eating wings without the mess.
We have a question from the audience.
Hi, Limor. First time, long time listener. can you make that actually just in the crock pot?
Yes. So
okay,
you can
so
actually
you don't
put it in
the
slow cooker and then but if you do, just allocate about maybe an hour or two just to make sure it's like nice and warm. But the whole point is everything is cooked, so there's nothing that needs to be made. So it's just really to make sure that it's nice and warm.
I'm sorry, we're out of time for questions.
Last one, sorry.
What's up here?
Okay, so here we have pizza wontons. These are actually my husband's favorite. So what you do is you get wonton wrappers right from the supermarket in the Asian section, or a lot of times they have them in the grocery store in the where they sell like the produce.
Yeah.
So to that, we're gonna add pizza sauce or marinara sauce.
Mm-hmm.
So you're gonna have you do that, Dan.
Sure, got it.
While you do that, I'm just gonna add some mozzarella cheese on top.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it?
Same temperature, 375 for about 10 to 15 minutes until it's nice and crispy and you have these delicious pizza wontons.
Oh, wow.
And what's nice about them is a lot of people have pizza on game day.
Right.
But it's really heavy, and so these are a much lighter way. You know, you want to have a lot of the food.
So you can have 12 of these instead of 6 slices of pizza.
Exactly.
Got it.
And they're really easy to do, and they're really delicious.
That is awesome.
So
I love these.
So all of this takes no time at all, really.
And so one of the things that I really like to do is really set things up that, you know, and then you can really enjoy the party so that you're not just constantly reheating.
Time.
And, you know, that's like the bane of my existence when it's like you're at someone's party and they're just like constantly microwaving.
Right.
So just put things in slow cookers and it'll make your life easier.
Can I just say, I have done all of Limor's things every year and every time my guests come over and they are super, super impressed.
Like
I'm not just saying that. They're like, where'd you find all this? And it is really important to have everything on the table and then you can really enjoy yourself,
yeah,
you know?
Exactly.
Limor, I always love when you come by.
Thanks so much, guys.
It.
And we're going to have all those ideas, by the way, posted on our website, pix11.com, as well for the step-by-step details.
Absolutely. Okay, so coming up, we're going to be right back. Stay with us for much more to come.